Have you ever wondered how a data scientist builds that highly inferring machine learning model? What are the various factors in his decisions? Have the technology changes influenced the decision-making process? I will give you the answers to these and similar questions in this short video. We have been using statistical techniques for building machine learning applications for last several years. The success of ANN DNN in developing AI applications has now opened up a new way for model development. A data scientist has now a choice between these two approaches. We now call the classical ML a good old-fashioned AI. It is still good, and you need to understand which path to follow while designing your new AI application. Another radical change that has come into model building is the data type. We no longer do analytics only on data sets created from traditional databases. We need to understand new data types, and that is text and image. So, what is the current process adopted by a modern data scientist while deciding between good old-fashioned AI and the ANN technology and doing analytics on the new data types? I will now start providing you with guidelines for designing ML applications in this modern AI era. The first question that you need to ask yourself is how much data is available to you for analysis and for model building. If your data set has just a few hundreds of data points or even just in thousands, do not think of using the new ANN technology. Training ANN requires an enormous amount of data. And if you consider DNN, you would need millions and billions of data points. So, the first rule is stick to good old-fashioned AI if your data sets are small. Most of you would be familiar with the process of classical ML development. I will now pinpoint the advances that will help you understand the approach taken by a modern data scientist while using classical ML. Your first task is to pre-process the data. You start by cleaning up the data set. The next is to encode character and string data columns. Then you use EDA to explore the data. Next, study the data distribution to identify correlated columns to reduce the features count. Finally, study data distribution to remove imbalances. After you prepare the data, the next task is mapping the problem. Here, you decide upon whether the current use case requires regression analysis or is it a classification problem. Now check if you have a labeled data set. This decides on the type of learning that you will use, supervised or unsupervised. Your next task is selecting the features and the targets. This is the most ideal task, where you would not only need a wonderful experience, but also a deep domain knowledge. Finally, comes the most hard task, and that is selecting an appropriate algorithm. A modern data scientist uses the newly developed tools for selecting the best performing algorithm and fine-tune its hyperparameters. You need to learn the use of these new tools to match the expertise of a modern data scientist. Having described the good old-fashioned AI development, let us now look at the modern development using the new technologies. I will now tell you what we require in developing ML models based on ANN techniques. These are the two major steps in ANN development. Your first task is to define a network architecture, which means to select the number of layers, the number of nodes in each layer, and the connection types between the layers. Next, you will need to decide on the loss and optimization functions to use for training the network. After you design the network, you train it over several epochs. Use early stopping features to end training when the desired training accuracy is reached. I will now mention the benefits of using ANN technology. These are the two major benefits. Let me describe them. The first benefit is that when you feed the data to the network, it is in small batches. Compare this with good old-fashioned AI, where in most situations, you need to load the entire data set into memory before you train the algorithm. See the limitations of classical ML in developing models on huge data sets. The second important benefit is automated feature selection. Remember, I mentioned that in good old-fashioned AI, there is no substitute to the expertise of a data scientist in feature selection. The feature selection is inherent in ANN, and thus you are spared of this extremely non-trivial task while using this new technology. Another enormous advantage given to us by ANN technology is transfer learning. You can reuse and extend somebody else's trained model for your own business use case. No more model development, training, testing, and so on. Just encash on somebody's knowledge and efforts. Today, the ML development has advanced to such a level that you, as a business person, need not spend your business money on asking somebody to develop models for data analytics. TechGiants now offer services beyond AutoML. What you need is just a data set, which obviously you have. You just upload your data set on their servers. They will do the entire data pre-processing, model building, testing, and so on, and finally come up with a highly inferring ML model ready to move to a production server. Isn't this really nice? However, this machine learning service has few limitations. These companies rarely provide you with the source code for you to fiddle with, which will make most of us uncomfortable in using the service. Another important aspect is that these companies typically charge you on a pay-per-use model that will bring in lots of uncertainties, as it is difficult to estimate the amount of resources that you would need for model training and the time to train the model. Having said all this, you see that machine learning now has come to an easy reach of even a fresh, just out of the school data scientist. Welcome to this new world of data science and be a data scientist. There are many industry openings. You just need to master the new skills. Good luck. Thank you for watching this video. If you like it, subscribe to Blockcity channel for more such upcoming videos.